I got a free 4K LG TV. A friend of my mom said her TV stopped working, so she bought a new one. So, let's take a closer look and see what's wrong and find out if it's fixable. I first plugged it in and attempted to turn it on, and I was greeted with the LG logo, followed by the webOS interface, which is LG's smart TV software. The LCD itself seemed to work fine, so I tried plugging in some devices, and the issue became apparent. All the outputs didn't work. The audio and component did work, though, so I knew the speakers were intact. After some troubleshooting and research, turns out a vast majority of older LG TVs, this one is from 2015 for reference, had a multitude of different issues. Unfortunately, bad quality control or something not only affected the G4, V10, Nexus 5, 5X, but even their TVs. The board obviously needed replacing, but I wanted to try to repair it first. I bought a cheap heat gun from Harbor Freight, and after melting my graphics card once, I noted not to go overkill. I saw a lot of people on YouTube with these flawed TVs that use the oven method, and obviously neither the heat gun method or oven method are the correct way to fix these electronics, but usually it works, for a short while anyway. I tried heating it up once and it didn't work. After the second time, it was obvious I fried the board, so we'll never figure out what was ever wrong with it. Anyways, I took to eBay to find a replacement board and found one, but it got sold and the only other one was like $200. Then I made a discovery. Another lineup of LG's 4K TVs on the lower end had a very similar board layout. In fact, it had all the same connectors the now roasted one had. The only obvious differences were that there were only two HDMI ports, and their layout was different, and the USB port was a little lower. I even compared TCON boards with that TV with the one I had, and the layout was basically identical. There's no telling what would happen if I installed this board, but I pulled the trigger and took my hard-earned $60 to eBay and hoped for the best. A few days later, the board arrived. The power supply had plenty of time to discharge, so it was safe to perform the installation. I attempted to mount the board, but only two of the holes lined up. Even then, it was obvious that this board is just a cut-down version of its bigger brother. It was originally for a 43-inch panel, and the one I have is for the 49-inch one. All the internal cables went in as normal, and I put some tape over the metal standoffs that would otherwise touch the bottom of the board and mounted it into place. It wasn't entirely secure, but the back panel should keep it in place once it's installed. Speaking of, the composite lines up perfectly, but I'll have to do a bit of modification to make things work. Anyways, I sealed up the back with four screws, and at this point, I didn't know what to expect. I connected it to my PS2 and connected the power cable. The standby light came on, and surprisingly enough, it turned on. The static screen wasn't too reassuring, and it didn't even look like webOS, but when I fired up the PS2, it worked perfectly. I tried the HDMI ports and was able to do full 4K 60Hz. I reset it to factory default and set it up with Wi-Fi, and that worked fine. Another theory of mine has been proved correct, and I essentially got a 4K TV for $60. We can finally retire our Philips 1080p TV from 2009. Yes, you heard me correctly. The picture quality, as expected, is pretty good. LG makes great displays, but something that our 11-year-old TV had that aged way better are the speakers. I cannot describe how much better our older TV speakers were. They aren't even firing at you like the LG. Both have 20-watt speakers, and while the Philips ones aren't the best of the best, I consider them good and much better than the LG one. I'll definitely need to find another audio solution. I did have to make some cuts to the back panel to get access to the HDMI, but once I did that, I closed it up for good. Overall, I'm really happy that I was able to fix this TV and replace our old one. The speakers really do need replacing though, so I'll need to replace the built-in ones soon. This was also a great way to reduce waste, as this would have been thrown away otherwise. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions or suggestions, please let me know in the comment section, and I'll do my best to get back to you. If you did enjoy the video, hit that like button, but if not, you know where to go. While you're there, consider subscribing to the channel, and enable notifications for more quality tech videos. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I'll see you later.